I don't want to step. Yeah. Skim it like this. Blend it, blend it. Yeah. We need to.
No, I'll do that.
How'd you do that?
Do you want it there?
Yeah. I'm trying to sort this out.
Is it yours?
Yeah. Okay. First time for everything. Waiting for a few more people to come on board. Oh, hey, everybody. How are we going to do that?
Hold it right there. Come on, use this. Oh, there you go.
There you go.
Let go. Let go. Oh.
Totally.
No, I've got it, I've got it, I've got it.
Yeah.
I got it.
Totally professional. Are we?
And then
I've disappeared.
And I used mine to watch the...
I've disappeared. I'm back. So I should... Oh, okay. So I've just got an email saying Robbie Williams is live on the internet. Let me see. Peak time.
Do you want to get people to check the connection? Make sure it's working.
What? People to check their connection?
Yeah,
I'm dark. I'm in the dark. And it's dark here.
Check it's the connection, I think. There we go. Don't pop that one.
This is so unorganised. Do you reckon it's this connection down here? Look.
Maybe, yeah.
No, but look. Look on YouTube.
That looks okay.
Looks okay.
You tell you what, I'll do this. It's my job. This will look good. I'll do this.
I'm not having you stand there for however long we're going to be doing this for. Ross. What should we do?
I don't mind.
Yeah, I can't. Listen, let me put this there. And I'll talk like that. How about, there you go. Come to Brazil, says Henrique Cesar. It's only 783 people. Where are you, everybody?
That looks good.
I said come say hello. Please give me a shout out. I'd probably be better if I gave you a shout out, if you give me something constructive to talk about. Oh my God, chat's going mental. Hello from Germany. Good morning from Geelong. Good morning, Geelong. So let's flop over to Twitter. Danielle Westbrook, 3 hours ago, said, he's a doll, that one, at Robbie Williams, but this made me chuckle. Ida is one cool dick for sure. Shout out to Danielle Westbrook. Hold tight, darling. She's referring to who's my celebrity crush, and yes, Daniela, you're my celebrity crush. Hey Robbie, when are you touring the US? I've waited 9 years to see you. 9 years? I haven't toured the US in, it's got to be 20 years. But hold tight, news might be coming. What did that say? Robbie, I'm Teresa that had surgery yesterday. Oh, bless you, darling. I hope you're good. Yes, Rob, is your trouble soon going to be a Christmas tree in a John Lewis advert? McBainbridge, you should be in charge of my, what's it called? Branding. I think that would be a good idea. But, no, I don't think it is a Christmas release. In fact, I'm not sure. I think it's probably just out now. But yes, it would be good on an advert. I think we might be too late to get it in. Oh, that works.
There you go. Sorry, mate.
Look what Leo's done.
Wow. He's sorry, mate.
That's okay.
I didn't think about that. How's that?
Mix it.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
Yeah?
It's perfect.
Sorry about that.
That's all right. I like it. There we go. Teddy was cute as a bridesmaid. You must be really proud. Yeah, she was really cute as a bridesmaid. And we were incredibly proud. So, another tweet that I've received just recently is from Danny Tetley. I've put a dank meme. Is it a meme or is it just a post?
It's a meme, isn't it?
I put a meme on my Instagram that says, "Look, find somebody that looks at you the way my wife looks at Danny Tetley." So go and check that out. Matthew Tolley is using a Tolly20 on Twitter is using a very, very old gag here, but I will tell it to you. I sat next to an insurance woman during a Robbie Williams concert, and through it all, she offered me protection. I've seen that quite a few times. People always used to say to me quite a lot, hey, loved you and Mrs. Doubtfire. If I heard it once, I heard it a thousand times. So what's going on? Let me go over to up front to see what the skinny is. Sarah Page says, what's your best moment so far? Sarah, what's my best moment so far? With what? Just in life? I think it's a bit of a too broad question. I'll tell you my best moment today was avoiding the fries and Peronese sauce that Leo's got hiding behind this counter that I can smell. It just smells of Nando's in here.
I did eat it over there and it's the bag gone.
Why did you leave the chips? Did you nail your own fries?
I had a full box.
You had a full box of fries?
I was going to save them till later.
Are you, you're sweating a lot? Is that, you're hot sweating? Day, yeah, but you have got a hoodie on. Yeah, so probably my best bit today, other than avoiding the Nando's and the fries, I went to see my acts, my contestants, rehearse today. Alame Choir, Misunderstood, United Vibes, and Akeisha and Aaliyah. And I'm very, very happy. This whole X Factor trip is bizarre. The roller coaster, the kaleidoscope of emotions that you have to deal with are incredible. You sort of, Saturday night, you want to make sure that you're looking after your contestants while also looking after yourself by doing a good job. I was telling my contestants all week, remember, you're bigger than the fear. And then obviously it was my first night and our first night as being judges. And then I was like, well, I've told them to remember the bigger than the fear. And if I can't take my own advice, then what good is my advice? So I overrid the fear. So Saturday night happened and it was 2 hours, which is a very long television show. I managed to say everything that I wanted to say. I was very supportive of the acts, but I think they deserve support. You know, these are real people that you get very attached to very quickly. Nobody on there's crap. Nobody on there's average. Everybody on there's really good. And it isn't a question of, I just big up my groups and then I'm not bothered about anybody else. I'm bothered about all the contestants on there. My dad was on a show called New Faces in 1974, and he went on there as a comedy act. And he won his round, but he didn't win his final. 44 years later, my dad still talks about what the judges said to him. And they were disrespectful. One of them said something slightly that you could perceive as being a bit, but not too bad. But my dad still talks about it. So for a lot of people, this is going to be the peak of their TV career. For many people, this is just going to be the start too. So I always used to watch things like Britain's Got Talent and think, I'm just going to tell, oh, why can't they tell the truth? That act's not very good. Or that act's boring. And then you realize that when you're in the studio, A, it's different. And B, these are real people with real feelings. And I'm glad that I could be of support to them. And plus last week, nobody need dissing. Nobody at all. Everybody sang really well, presented themselves really well. So yes, today, my favorite bit of today was gonna go see my contestants and also watching the kids on the trampoline. That was very sweet. And then reading them a bedtime story. And Ted just making up her own songs. She's figured out how to do the iPad and video herself. And she's incredible, isn't it? She's doing sketches and she's doing songs.
She's like, don't listen, I'm going to record it, then you can listen.
Yeah, put your hands in your ears, Danny, and close your eyes. Then she makes up a song. And
with a melody.
With a melody.
And a chorus.
And a chorus. And then
dance.
And a dance too. And then she plays it. It's going to be difficult keeping her off the stage. She said the word friggin' the other day. Dad, we'll do this, it's going to be friggin' amazing. I didn't even bring it up.
No, no.
I didn't say anything. No. Oh, love that she's writing her own song, says Nita Who. Yeah, she is writing her own song, so she has done for a long time. Vivian79 says, will you sing with Take That? I'm sure I will, but if you're referring to, oh, the X Factor. I don't know. I think I might be. There's nothing set in stone. I don't know if they, A, want me to sing with them, Factor. We want your new songs with, we want your new song with Liam and Noel Gallagher. That's going to be a very difficult anti-Mar, considering they both hate me. So I can't see that happening. And they hate each other. So I don't think the first time that they're going to be in a room together is to write a song with me. Winners Under the Radar 3 coming out. Love you, says Kaylee Smith. Well, Kaylee Smith.
Just got to shoot the photo.
Got to shoot the photo, which we might be shooting tonight.
And then we'll get to up and online to pre-order.
Traditionally, it's been a naked photo.
Any ideas?
Any ideas? Because we're thinking of shooting that tonight, but it's a bit weird. Because, like, the first photo that we did for Under the Radar 1 was just a bet that I lost on holiday. Whoever lost the card game had to jump in the pool naked. So that was caught. And then the second one was me just walking naked around our grounds at our house in Wiltshire, and Ida took that. So the first one was sort of like, wee! And the second one was like, oh, it's the missus. But the third one is just going to be you and me, Leo, with my tackle out.
I could put it on a self timer. I'll leave the room. Do you think?
I'm not wanking. It's okay. Showbiz. That's what happens in showbiz. Just Red Reveal. Awesome, says Ruth Lindsay. Thank you. What's your favourite album of yours? I think mine will be Intensive Care. Ghost is one of my favourite tunes of yours and A Place to Crash. You should sing them live more. Yes. That's the thing is about singing live is that if I did it by majority, well, if I did it by majority rule, I'd be singing all the singles, which is what I do. But if I did them individually, my gig would take me 7 hours. I would love to sing Ghosts and I would love to sing A Place to Crash. But you should see the energy shift when you play something that they're not really familiar with. In a stadium with 80,000 people looking at you, where you're scared already, because it's a scary thing, trying to conduct that much energy. You know, when you play something they don't know, they're like, oh, don't know this one. Yeah, but you five at the front do. So I hear what you're saying, and my set list would be very different if it was left to me. But so many people come to see me perform because they know I'm an entertainer. And so many people come to see me perform because they want to be entertained and not necessarily because they know all my stuff, which I've tested out before. Like when I sang the Heavy Entertainment Show, not the one on that, but on Under the Radar Volume 1. I sang it in Paris and literally 10 people knew it. Were you in Paris that night? Is Charlie an entertainer? Does he like to sing? Not yet, but he's started to. He just stops and he sees Ted do it. And then he goes, yeah, yeah, rock and roll. Yeah, yeah, I'm the greatest. Yeah, yeah, rock and roll. Yeah, yeah, I'm the greatest. So that's his song right now, but he's not. Ted, ever since she's been walking and talking, was singing. Maybe Charlie's a slow burn and he'll... Maybe Charlie will manage Teddy. Did you record Go Now, Mr. Bojangle said. No, I didn't record Go Now. In fact, Go Now by me, Robbie Williams, is a song that I recorded after I left Take That with a guy called Owen Morris. And Owen Morris was the producer of the first two Oasis albums. We went to Wales and we recorded in a cow shed. And in this cow shed was the original mixing desk that Queen used. Literally, there was like us and a bunch of cows and red wine and party favors. And we wrote a song that went like this. And this is the demo. And I suppose we were trying to be the Pet Shop Boys meets Massive Attack. This needs producing. I think it could still be a tune. Keeping the original vocal. 20-year-old Robbie. So it's about a guy going out with a guy and then the guy leaving him. Don't ask me.
Off the wall, it never really fit at all. I didn't like Van Gogh anyway. Close the doors and off the light. There's something really wrong tonight. I think that we should finish. I might.
I actually could duet with myself on that song.
You're going up in viewers.
I could duet 44-year-old Robbie Williams with 21-year-old Robbie Williams. Have you ever been asked to the Pyramid Stage at Glastonbury? Did I play the Pyramid Stage at Glastonbury? Robbie Williams, Glastonbury. Let's have a look. Let me see if it's the Pyramid Stage.
Does an angel contemplate my fate?
If you must.
Or do they know?
This is Angels at Glastonbury.
When you're gray and old.
I think this might be the main stage, the Pyramid Stage.
That salvation lets their wings unfold. So when I'm lying in my bed, thoughts running through my head,
and I feel the love is dead, I'm loving angels instead.
So the answer is yes. I think I did play the Pyramid Stage at Glasgow. Hello, Glastonbury people. I'd like to come back and do it again. Bring one singer back from the dead. Who would it be and why? Wow. I was thinking about the 27 Club. Is it 27 or 24?
7.
27. Instantly, I go to Freddie Mercury. Because every time I see documentaries about him or just watch him, I just think he's angelic, a proper God. But I would guess that after a committee meeting, I would probably choose Amy Winehouse because she was cut off in her prime. And I was just today thinking about, I wonder where she could have got to or what she would be doing right now. Whether she would be on the judging panel of the X Factor, doing Ida's job.
Yeah.
I doubt it. She's a few years away from doing that gig, or was. Who would you choose to play you in a film about your life? Are you a little gay, says Dorito Bandito? A little bit. I'm a little bit. I'd like to think so. I'm heavily influenced by gay culture and West Indian culture, Caribbean culture, black culture. So, huh? Oh, in fact, I was in a Caribbean orchestra for a little while. And I played the triangle. I didn't do much. I just stood at the back and ting. Thank you very much. So anyone said you look like Bruce Willis. So am I a little gay is the answer. Yes, I am a little bit gay, but not with the cock stuff. I've not got round to that yet, but there's always a yet. What is the angel song that you speak of? The angel song that I speak of is a hit from 1997 that catapulted me into the stratosphere. And it's about Saint Michael, Archangel Michael. If you haven't seen pictures of Archangel Michael, there aren't any, but there are some images on Google, and he's a badass. Trust me, Daddy. Do you communicate with Max Beasley lately? Yes, I do. Max Beasley's just had a new baby. God bless Max and his missus. And I love Maxton. He's my meat. Do you decorate your own Christmas tree? Actually, Ida's trying to make it a tradition at the house where we do that. And she's like really pleased about it and wants me to be excited and wants it to be a thing. And I don't want it to be a thing, because
it's not.
Yes. Have you ever decorated your own tree or house? The answer is, change your haircut, says Mikhail Gab. Change your face. Will you be playing soccer, eh? Do you watch Port Vale versus, oh, Robbie, I booked a holiday. What's your favorite Christmas song? It's this one. Hold on. It's this one. It's coming up. Hold tight.
What? Can I have an advert?
Let's get through the adverts. 3, 2, 1.
Today at 5
p.m. Mix it, blend it. She's like Danny Tetley without a beard. So, anybody want to hear a Christmas song that I've written? I would get Leo to suggest which one, but I'm not playing the one you want me to play.
Okay, what about...
Oh, I'm not playing The Darkest Night now, because that's probably the big hit.
What about...
California Christmas? Let's not... No, because I might use that for an advert.
I'm just thinking the best ones.
Okay, how about California Christmas?
Yeah.
Come on, California, keep your head up. We've got...
Can you kind of hear the list?
Yeah. Or we could play Bad Sharon. You know the song. I'll do this. I'll sing it for you. See you, Pam Dowler. Bit of a... Pre-thing. 18
Christmases ago,
I went all in, cause there was something about this town that kept on calling. It's not in my blood or in my DNA, but it held my hand when I ran away. I'm a lost angel with my demons, and I say happy Christmas, folks, and happy holiday season. Come on. Come on, California, keep your head up. It's Christmas, it's all good. No, it's never gonna snow in Hollywood. I love you, it's all good this Christmas. The sun still looks strange to me, but we've got central casting, so he's the best you've ever seen. I saw him with his reindeer down Rodale,
outside
Louis Vuitton, and Santa's little helpers were helping wealthy mums. But it's all good, it still feels like Christmas. So I got out of my car and I handed him my wish list, and it went, come on, California, keep up Christmas, it's so good. Though it's never gonna snow in Hollywood, I love you, it's so good this Christmas. That's all you're getting. Two verses, two choruses. Wait, what the fuck did I stumble on? Somebody just said. So that's one of my Christmas songs. Do you know how many Christmas songs I've written? That many. That's how many Christmas songs I've written. Problem is, nobody really likes new Christmas songs. People like covers. So it's a bit of a mess, really, because I've written 22.
Wow.
22 Christmas songs, yeah. Do you like Cat Williams? Yeah, I do like Cat Williams. He's a comedian. It ain't easy out here for a pimp. It's hard out here for a pimp. Yeah, I do like Cat Williams. He went all Illuminati, though, didn't he? Rob, could you give me a channel, a shout out, please? Could really help. Have you ever been to Wakefield, Yorkshire? Yes, I have. I know Flix is in Huddersfield. Take That's first gig as a five piece. Well, as any piece, was in a nightclub called Flix in Huddersfield, which is not too far away from Wakefield. I'm sure I did some gigs in Wakefield, would take that. Gordon Ramsay chases cows there. There was a tiny one. Please, can I please have a shout? I have a broken wrist. There you go. Let me jump over to Twitter and see what's happening. Oh, Take That Fan at Take That Fan always says, my heart wasn't wrong when decided to love Robbie Williams last century. Is the most generous artist on earth. Big shout out to you if you're watching. Rosalina 42086309 says, Robbie Williams' daughter Teddy was so cute at the royal wedding. Bless you, yes, she was. Angelina 19811466 says, Robbie Williams' daughter Teddy was so cute at the royal wedding. Anastasia 442-64072 said, Robbie Williams' daughter was Teddy was cute at the royal wedding. That must be like a robot. Any robots out there want to boost my numbers on my Twitter or my Instagram, I'll happily take you. Angelina 188-8501 saying the same thing about Teddy. That's weird. And then there's something in German written by Sweet Tea Sweet Angie. I'm going to read it in German. Even if it's a diss, I don't care. Das hat der real Robbie Williams ein verschnickt verdient. And then there's this emoji, crying with tears. Taj das was Wolf wird den deutschen Robbie Williams. Right? The Deutsch Robbie Williams seit us wie Ricky Martin. I know. We get the den als Robbie Williams double Dutch, the seit dem Deutsch. Überhaupt nicht anlicht. What does that mean? Then there's a gif of Ricky Martin just looking incredible. Met Ricky Martin at a wedding just recently. What a lovely man. I want to do something with Ricky Martin. I want to do something with Adam Lambert. Maybe Adam Lambert and Ricky Martin and me should get together and open a Turkish baths. Larry for president says out Robbie Williams, this jacket, Gucci at Harry Styles. So people are referring to the Instagram that was put up earlier of me with my new Gucci jacket on. David Williams, I see you, asking where my jacket's from. Your mum. The Deutsch Robbie Williams seit wer us wiz Robbie knocked klickt a wee Robbie. Ich dacht, das sind die Zivi. No. Is it Dutch? Is that Dutch? Yeah, that's Dutch. Okay, so there's lots of things going on tonight. There must be a double of me on the television in Holland. I can't do the thing. Let's go back over to...
How's the meme doing?
Up front. Pick 10. Be careful, the gay rumours will start again, says Tonya. I don't mind a bit of that. It's all good. Holly Rogers said, our wedding, lol, you mean the royal wedding. Yes, I did, but I was trying to keep it on the down low. Oh yes, Adam Lambert, that would be amazing, said Nita Awu. Evening, Robbie, your dad is such a legend, Lewis Barry. Yeah, he is. Let's go over to my dad's Twitter, which is Papa
Papa Pete
229 and see what my dad's been up to. Oh. Google's saying, niet. It's 1p. Papa Pete. 229? No. Pete Conway. Let's see what my dad's been up to today. Oh. Oh. Ollie Mers is looking for dad dancers. My knees won't let me or I'll be first in line. Perhaps it's for the best. And then there's a nice picture with my dad and Ollie Mers underneath that. Is my dad putting a picture of us up? A gig that we did in front of 18,000 people. An incredible night. And he's putting a picture up and he says, looking forward to moments like this. And who wouldn't? That is because me and my dad are heading down to South America. Next week to go and do gigs in Paraguay, Mexico, Brazil. Brazil? No, Chile.
Yeah.
Coming down to South America. It's been too long. Operation is locked, rotate device. How'd you do that?
Is it back on?
No, it says operation is, orientation is locked. Anybody know what to do?
Yeah, I figured it out. Okay.
Eternity says, I want to see some of your paintings. I'm sure the others here want to too. Well, my paintings aren't here. They're in Los Angeles. And yeah, I would like to show you my paintings. But I'm a bit scared to show them to anybody because... You know, I do my job, which is my job, and then people go, you shouldn't do your job, we hate you. So then you go and do paintings, and I'm sure people are not going to like them. But I'll get them out when I'm happy with them, but not for now. Does Leo write lyrics, asks Eternity.
I do what?
You do what?
Yeah.
Did you do what on something?
Did I write that lyric, you know, the...
No.
What?
Angels,
is it?
Angels. Yeah. You wrote Angels too. Yeah. Jesus, you're not the only one. What got you to paint inspired you? I'm a creative. I like doing things. And when I'm busy, I'm really busy. And then when I'm not, I'm not. And I can have a month off here and there. And after 2 weeks, I just get bored. And my fingers and my mind want to do something. It's very therapeutic. Ha! Right. So, let's go to Twitter. And see what's over there. Are you ever going to perform with Michael Bublé? Somebody said that would be cool. Lucy Champion. Hi, Lucy Champion. I can't wait to see Robbie Williams and Take That at the Band Musical on the 4th of December. Always love a Robbie Take That reunion. Do you know something I don't know? Am I doing that? Is that what I'm doing? Robbie Williams, Joanna Kay says, want some cake. Yeah, but I've had to turn down cake for a while. Jane Becky Perky says, the new music on your album is looking good, Robbie. So is yourself watching you live on YouTube. Thanks, Jane. Okay, this is for the heads out there. Hold tight. Under the Radar Volume 3, new tune. In the area. I tell you what, you have to be precise with this new spanning thing on iTunes. Under the Radar Volume 3.
Yeah, one letter, it's not coming up, is it?
Yeah, it didn't used to do that.
Right. It doesn't autocorrect either, does it?
Okay, so what I'm going to put on... coming out. This isn't it. I tried searching for it today and I can't find it. Hey man, says Maurizio Farfan.
I walk around these empty streets, they say there's nothing left for me. I say there's no one here for you. Down in the land of the blind, the one-eyed king, you stole my mind. And I let him. Everything I like's illegal, seductive, addictive. In my world, corrosive, destructive. But I've got kind words in my heart. It's a passion, your passion.
That's Under the Radar Volume 2 too. So, somebody's just asked me what's my favourite Pet Shop Boys song. I don't know if I've got a... you can pick a favourite because their pop's the best pop. And they've written a lot of incredible pop records, but this one spoke to me a lot when I was 16. Just join Take That.
A nervous boy in several ways. I never knew the world could operate this way. I was nervous when
we stopped to speak, and the world came crashing around my feet. We don't talk of love, we're much too shy, but nervously we wonder when and why. So I love this tune. A nervous boy, in spite of which I never thought I could tremble as much as this. Your flashing eyes and sudden smile are never quite at ease, and neither am I. Oh, we'll talk about it all some night, but nervously we never get it right. From the start, I approved of you. Right from the moment you turned to face me. Takes me back. A few times I used to bike from Stoke-on-Trent to Manchester to go and have meetings.
Really?
With Take That in the early days.
That
well, it was 50 miles. Well, I say I used to bike there and bike back. I used to bike there and then get the train back.
How long did it take? 2 hours?
I don't know. It'd take a bit longer than 2 hours, I think.
Yeah. Music. What? Oh, no music, is there?
But I would be listening to that record. What date is Under the Radar coming out? I don't know. Jack says Oasis are better than Take That. Not at fucking dancing, they're not. Robbie, Radiohead or Muse? I like that. What's that? What's that Muse song? Is it called Mental or something? Madness. What a tune this is. Play that song. Hold tight, the internet. Mix it. Blend it.
Can't get these memories out of my mind. Some kind of madness has started to evolve. I try so hard to let you go. But some kind of madness is swallowing me whole. Yeah. I have finally seen the light.
For some reason, it reminds me of a Queen song. I'll go with Muse tonight. Yeah, I was at Abbey Road Studios and I walked past Tom York and he saw me, and I, of course, I love Radiohead, and he saw me and he went, Robbie Williams, like that. And just thought, oh, that's upset me. Like I was a figure of fun to you, Tom. I'm looking at you, Tom. See, that was like 20-something years ago. I just relived it like it was yesterday. It's what humans do. So, harking back to what I said before about the X Factor. Be nice. Unless you can't stand who's in front of you. And I can stand all of them. Majorly. Just texted, I'll be a friend, play Pet Shop Boys nervously. And it sounds up your alley, hubby. Fucking Robbie. Laugh my fucking arse off. Do you like Muse's Starlight? I probably know that one, but I don't know the names. TV celebrity or pop star? Well, I've done pop star. Currently enjoying TV celebrity. Test my mettle, something new, fun. Could all end in tears. Hey, Wobby, did you get that song I wrote for you and Ida and sent via Twitter? No, Paul, I didn't. And to be honest, I write my own songs, so I probably wouldn't listen. Plus, people sue you. I wrote that song and he stole it from me, so God bless you for writing it, but I won't be listening. Come back down here. Cancel. Let's see. Hey, Robbie, I bet Hollywood are listening now. Got both signed under the radars. Bloody fantastic. Roll on to release date soon, hopefully. What colour of socks have I got on? Pez is better than FIFA. All right, Pev. Sure. What's your thoughts on trophy hunting, says Nicola Davies. It's not something I'm into. It's not something that appeals to me. I don't think I'll be trophy hunting any time in my life. Hi, Robbie, can you say my name? Loads of questions on your forum too. Let's jump to my forum and see what they're saying. Bohemian Rhapsody, said Marley Shower. Such a great film. If you get the chance, Rob, I recommend it. Thanks for the review of the film, Marley. I think that I only watch films on aeroplanes. I don't really watch films at home and I don't really go to the cinema. Last time we went to the cinema was with the kids and we watched the new Winnie the Pooh movie, which just was lovely. Heartbreaking and, oh, give me the feels. Give me the total feels. But before that, I think it might have been a year before that since we went to the movies again, which was to see another kids film. So if I do watch it, I'm going to be watching it on the aeroplanes. Dan Woon said you're reuniting with Take That. True or false? I think I might be. I don't know. I think I'd remember. I would remember, wouldn't I?
Yeah.
I think there was something about something. But look, literally 50 things happen every day. And you're answering questions, doing things, going, oh yeah, you know, I'm going to South America. There's things that I'm doing. There's interviews that I've been doing. I'm sure I'm doing something with the boys. But I don't know. Your voice are getting weak. Please, for your fans, save your voice. Fuck off, Johnny. My voice is better than it's ever been. My voice is better than it was when I was 22, 23, 24, 25. It's just not warm right now. I want to see Louis, says Alex, is here. Hi, Robbie. When was the last time? You remember nothing like me. I remember nothing. That's right. Say to Leah from me. When was the last time you saw Gary Barlow? I saw him in Los Angeles. 5 weeks ago. Have you lost weight, says Andrew Dubini. I think I'm the same weight that I've been for the last 4 months. Have I lost a bit? Mm-hmm. What I hate about me is this bit. I want that to go. So I've probably got to lose another 14 pounds, which I'm going to get done in January. So yeah, Gaz played me the Take That songs. Is the Greatest Hits out yet? Take That. I don't know if the album's actually out.
I think they did a remake of one of the songs.
Everything Changes. Yeah, there's a remake.
Is that the single from the Greatest Hits?
Everything Changes. Remix. Remix! Blend it! Everything Changes! No. Have they released Prey?
Oh, I think it was that one, yeah.
The remix? Oh, here we go. It's the Odyssey mix. Let's have a listen at Pray by Take That. This isn't it. It's an advert.
When the time grew near for me to show my love, the longer I stayed away for, hiding from a word I need to hear now.
Don't think I'll hear it again. But the nights are always warm with you.
I see you, Jack. Motorhead doing this would be good.
Just holding you right by my side. And the morning always comes too soon. Before I even close my eyes, yeah. All I do each night is pray. Hoping that I'll be a part of you again.
Fuck off, Johnny, I'm not losing my voice, dickhead.
All I do each night is think, yeah. Of all the times I close the door to keep my love within. Forget the past, I'll understand that. Can't understand why I did this to you. And all of the days and the nights, oh, I regret it. I never showed you my love. But the nights were always warm with you.
Great work, lads. I think I'll be doing a bit of that if I do another greatest hits. Not loud enough. Not loud enough. Come on. Let's go. Come on, lads.
Your man, win some, lose some, it's all the same to me. That's what I say. The only card I need is the ace of spades, the ace of spades. Devil, going with the flow, it's all a game to me. Seven or 11, snake eyes watching you. Double up or quit, double stake or split, the ace of spades, the ace of spades. Forget the Joker.
Shout out to the man in heaven, Lemmy, who's from Stoke-on-Trent, same as me. Burslem Posse in the house. Actually, that's the Burslem crest, and that's for Lemmy. Let's go to chat. Will you join Take That at the band gala in December, says USJ? I don't know. Do you manscape, says Rachel? Yes, I do, but I overdo it. I sort of go mental with the shears. But I'm not enjoying being this hairy as a 44-year-old.
I shave my arms.
You shave your arms?
Yeah.
So then, but I sort of like... I get and I shave all of that, and Ida doesn't like it.
Same.
She's, are you shaved all that
no,
too?
No, I'm not allowed.
You're not allowed to shave? By your missus?
Wow.
That's how they get you. They just slowly
like
take over.
Yeah.
And it starts with hair.
Does it? What's
and then
nice?
It ends up with houses. And then it ends up with three kids. Going on to five. Robbie, what's your favourite song written by you? Love Hurts by Nazareth. Viva La France. Monkey. Are you excited to come to South America? Of course I am. I will wax you, Robbie, says Joanne Black. Make a song with Liam G, Rob. Stop the beef. Make a song like Shame with Gary. Would be great, mate. Literally me and Liam Gallagher singing Shame is the funniest thing I've thought about today. When are you going to come to Manchester? I was there. I did quite a bit of Manchester last year. How many more songs left to put on the album? What can I play you? I think I played you everything over the course of the last few weeks. There's a song called A Guy Called Robbie, a song called Reality Killed a Video Star, Like Me, Nothing, Indestructible, The Impossible, Good People, Gold. That's only eight. That can't be right. Let me do that again.
You took one off, didn't you?
Did I? It's Christmas. Voodoo Ray. Oh, yeah. Voodoo Ray. Reality Killed the Video Star. People Like Me. Nothing. Indestructible. The Impossible. Hunting for You. Good People. Gold. Oh, that's nine. Mixed with...
God bless America.
Yes, Julia.
He can swing like a bastard and can rock all night long. Yes, he went to rehab. Drugs and drink took him low, but we'll still make rude box and give rap a go.
That's going on there. But I need to add some songs. Under the Radar Volume 3. Let me take to my computer. Sorry about pecking my nose. What could I add? Home Again. Get on with the show. Bye bye. Ah. Oh. This is a song I did with Take That. But I sing out of key in my verse, so I'm not putting it on. But it's good.
Blue world, your fate is calling. A blue world that lost control. A new world, our final curtain call. Look how we've come together just when we reach the end. In Requiem, you'll know how my young we were and feel how much it hurts. We might be lovers, but we're holding hands. We might be living, but we're making plans. Below a bleeding sky, watching our mothers cry. It seems forever wasn't long enough. You know we always lose the ones we love. We're more monetary masters, this fragile blue world with a cruel sunlight burning in our eyes.
Is that the voice of a man that can't sing anymore? What kinds of cigarettes do you stop? Do you intend to smoke? Do you intend to stop? Yes, I intend to stop. January. Copyright strike, lad, says. Whatever people say I am is what I'm not. Got to be a full frontal for the album cover. Cover it with a dolphin, says Rachel. Beautiful lyrics. Thank you, Emma Brass. Yeah, fuck off, Johnny. Says, not me. But thank you for being concerned about my voice. Fuck off, Johnny, says Johanna Nice Arse. Naked Bike Twat. It was me. There we go. John and I saw, said, is he still alive? I'm nearly home to start watching the YouTube live. Ha ha, Marley. I'm just about to end it. Who the fuck is Johnny? Says Wine Bank. Do you wear your tiger underwear? Yes, I do, but I haven't got it on right now. Do you remember our live chat? My name is Sir Tomster. I showed you my guitars. I would love to play you a song. No, I don't remember. Do I remember Requiem from the list of songs that you chosen for the tip? Yeah, Requiem was what a tune. Okay, everybody. I'm going to go for a cigarette, but I'm going to come back because I'm enjoying myself. What's that I hear? Please come back, Robbie. Done.